Hello everyone. Continuing the video series on how to use the MetaTrader 4S net platform. In this video I will guide you on how to execute trading orders. The MetaTrader 4 platform provides us with 6 orders, including 2 direct market orders at the current price and 4 pending orders. There are 2 different approaches to executing trading orders. For more details, please follow along in the video. This is the Exness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Exness platform. We are a leading development partner of Exness. If you're new to Exness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Exness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Exness Market website to explore more about Exness. As introduced at the beginning of the video, on this MetaTrader 4 platform, we can place 6 orders, 2 direct orders at the current market price, which are sell and buy orders, and 4 pending orders, buy limit, sell limit, buy stop, and sell stop. Before introducing the operations to execute these orders, let's understand how these orders work. First, let's talk about market orders, which are buy and sell orders. For a buy order, if we anticipate that the product price will go up and the current price is already good, we will proceed to place a buy order immediately. If the product price does go up as expected, our order will be profitable. However, if the product price continues to go down, our order will incur a loss, and we will need to cut our losses. If we anticipate that the product price is likely to go down and the current price is already good, we will proceed to place a sell order immediately. If the product price does go down as expected after we place a sell order, that order will be profitable. If the product price continues to go up, that order will incur a loss. For the pending buy orders group, we have buy limit and buy stop orders. A buy limit order is a pending buy order at a price lower than the current market price. For example, if we have a historical chart like this, and this is the current product price, we predict that the product price may still go down but only for a short period before continuing to go up. In this case, we will place a pending buy limit order at this position, the position where we expect the product price to go down. When the product price actually goes down to the position where we set the buy limit, that buy limit order will convert into a buy order. Subsequently, if the product price goes up, the order will be profitable, and if the price continues to go down, the order will incur a loss. For a buy stop order, we also expect the product price to go up, but in this case, we believe that the product price is highly likely to go up immediately. However, going up immediately carries a risk at this position. At the resistance level above, we are concerned that when the price goes up and touches this resistance level, it may go down again. So, we will not place a buy order immediately at the current price. Instead, we will wait for the price to truly go up, and if the price surpasses this resistance level on the left, it will confirm an upward trend. At that point, we will place a buy stop order at the position we marked here. Because of the resistance factor on the left, we do not place a buy order immediately at the current price, but rather wait for it to break past that resistance level before we buy. So, a buy stop order is a buy order at a price higher than the current market price. And that's how it works. For the pending sell orders group, it works similarly to the pending buy orders group. A sell limit order means we will wait to sell at a price higher than the current market price. We also expect the price to go up, then continue to go down, so we will wait to sell at the top. However, if we expect the product price to continue going down but it needs to break past a resistance level below, then it will confirm a downward cycle. At that point, we will proceed to place a sell stop order at this position below, which may be slightly lower than the resistance level on the left. There are 2 ways to execute trading orders. One is to operate directly on the display screen, on the product price chart. The second is to use the new order button. First, I will guide you on how to quickly execute trading orders by operating directly on the chart. Here, I am demonstrating on a demo account. And first, I will introduce how to execute market orders. To execute a market order, first, we will adjust the trading volume in the box in the upper left corner. Note that we want to trade a certain product, So we will go to the chart of that product and execute the trading order on that product's chart. For example, here I have the Uzi product pair. So I will go to the upper left corner and adjust the trading volume. For example, here I adjust the trading volume to 0.05 units. The unit here is in lots. After adjusting the trading volume, I will proceed with the trading orders. If I believe the current position is a good position to execute a sell order, I will click the sell button. When we first log into the trading platform and click the buy, sell button for the first time, the one-click trading window will appear. You just need to click I accept system and condition. Then click OK. Now you can quickly execute trading orders. I will click the sell order again. You see, very quickly, I have executed a sell order. If we believe the current position is a good position to execute a buy order, we will click the buy button. And before that, we will also adjust the trading volume here. You see, when we click the buy, sell button or perform quick trading, it will not display the stop loss or take profit values here because we haven't set those values yet. You can click and hold the left mouse button on the order we are trading. You can drag it up or down to set the take profit or stop loss position, depending on whether our order is a buy or sell order. This is currently a sell order. So when I drag it up, it will set the stop loss position for me. When I drag it down, it will set the take profit position for me. You can also double click on the order to adjust the take profit and stop loss positions more precisely. After adjusting, click the modify button below. For example, here I will adjust the stop loss position. I will change it to 149.7. For example, then I will click modify. Now I have adjusted the stop loss position. If you want to place pending orders, to set the volume for those pending orders, first, we will also adjust the volume in this section. So you will adjust the volume of the pending order in this exact box. After that, to execute pending orders with a set price higher than the current market price, we will move the mouse pointer above the current price. Right click on that position. Here, at a position higher than the current market price, we can place a sell limit or buy stop order. So you go to the trading section. Select buy stop if you want to place a buy stop order. If you want to place a sell limit order, you can select it directly from outside. After you place that pending order, you can also left click on it. Hold and drag it to the desired position. There, I just moved the sell limit order to a new price level. For pending orders with a placement syntax for a price level lower than the current market price, we will move the mouse pointer down and right click on it. We will select buy limit or go to trading and select sell stop. I can also left click on it and drag it to the desired position to change the pending order placement position. When I want to modify this pending order, I can also double click on it to adjust the information here. So, with these on-screen operations, we can very quickly execute market orders as well as pending orders. Another way to execute these orders is to use the new order button. We will click on it. In this section, to adjust the trading volume, we will adjust it in the volume section. For example, here I will set it to 0.2 lots. If I want to enter a direct order at the current market price, I will leave the information here as default. Specifically, in the type section, it is currently set to market execution, which means a direct order at the current market price. If we want to execute a sell order, we click sell by market. If we want to execute a buy order, we click buy by market. If we want to execute pending orders, we will adjust the type section and select pending order. After that, in the type section of pending order, we will select one of the four pending orders that we can place on the MetaTrader 4 platform. After selecting the order type, we will set the price level for that pending order here. And note that this price level must be set correctly. For example, here I am placing a sell limit order. So this price level must be a price level higher than the current market price. It must be located above. However, if we set a price level lower than the current market price in this sell limit order, this order will not be executed. So, above, I have introduced to you the operations to execute trading orders on the MetaTrader 4 platform. I hope that the information I provided is useful to you. In the next video, I will guide you on how to manage these trading orders. And specifically, I will guide you on how to set a trailing stop to help you protect the profits you have earned in your trading orders. I will end the video here. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to give the video a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel publishes them.